dusting the beach sand off of my jeans, I mustered up just enough courage to look at her properly for the first time that night. She was still sitting on the mini hill we had made for ourselves earlier that evening, head thrown back, beer in one hand and a lit cigarette in the other, sunglasses tugging at her t-shirt neckline deeper than it already was. She caught me looking and threw a puzzled look and laughed. "What's wrong? Why do you have that look on your face?" she asks, smiling coyly. Nothing. Yeah, nothing. I shake my head off. It's now or never. I muster up just enough courage to ask her, do you maybe want to come over to my place tonight? I said it. There was a huge rush of adrenaline and blood shooting up my head, and my heart was pumping blood like it was a matter of life and death. Well, it was. You see, I have been wanting to bring her home since the first time I saw her. No, wait, that's not right. I had been wanting to bring her home since the first time she had looked at me. I'm a writer. I might be a writer, but I work on logic. And logic told me I belong nowhere near her. She was way out of my league. She was cool and chic and made all the boys go weak in the knees. And I was a bespectacled gamin who knew more about hydrogen and helium than hush puppies. We were from different planets, and so I knew I had nothing to interest her. I don't know why then had I just asked her to come home with me. Maybe it was the beard. Maybe it was the way her mouth held the smoke. Maybe it was just the sun and the beach. But something, and I do not know what, but something clamored at my insides and beat at my brain till I finally just asked her. She snapped her fingers at me. "Where do you get lost all the time? Well, anyway, I'm not going to walk home at this hour, and your home is close by, so I'm coming home with you. Go get your stupid scooter. I'll take this beer bottle, dispose them, and I'll find you." She gets up, turns around, dusts off her jeans, and I'm staring again. And she catches me staring at her again. I think this is it. There is no redemption from this. There is no way she'll forget me. I definitely have crossed a few boundaries. And my mind is going on this rampage of how early can I just walk into the sea until she snaps her fingers again at me. "You really need to stop staring off into space. Oh, by the way, I hope you like blueberries." I was taken aback, so I shook my head clear and asked, "Blueberries?" She said, "Yeah, that's what my chapsticks taste of." She turns around and walks away as if she hadn't just agreed to spend the night with me, as if she just hadn't given hope to a dying ember. I let go of a breath I didn't know I was holding, and I fall back, giddy, on the little hill we had made that evening. I guess humans are meant to defy logic.